and a new day will dawn for those who stand long. And she's buying a stairway to heaven.
Finish your preach.
Led Zeppelin, woo! Stairway to Heaven. Did you know Led Zeppelin's Stairway to Heaven is considered the most famous rock song of all time? If you are a Generation X, like I am, you probably had that song played at your prom. It was probably even you had your prom as the theme of Stairway to Heaven. The song has won awards in and has been described in many genres. Progressive rock, folk rock, hard rock, classic rock, renaissance. It even won the falsetto section award. Ooh, that's... You know, I would listen to this song when I was young all the time, so much that I grew sick of it. You ever had one of those before? You listen to it and you're just kind of sick of it. It was kind of like it had a spell over you because it was 8 minutes and 1 second. I mean, that's a long song. Yeah, today, instead of it being the number one rock song and how it had a spell over young people, maybe, I want you to pay attention to the words. Because the words describe our land, our culture today. There's a lady who's sure of all that glitter is gold, and she's buying a stairway to heaven. For the piper is calling, your stairway lies on the whispering wind. Your shadow's taller than your soul. For there walks a lady we all know, who shines white light and wants to show how everything still turns to gold. For she is buying a stairway to heaven. What a song that matches the philosophy of our culture. Many big ideas have struggled over the centuries to dominate the planet. To dominate the planet. Fascism, communism, polytheism, liberalism, conservatism. But only one has achieved total supremacy. Consumerism. Materialism. Its attraction, all that glitter, has robbed its followers of reason and good sense. It has created unattainable inequalities, social and mental problems. It is more powerful than any cause or even any religion. It has reached into almost every corner of the globe. Consumerism, materialism is more than just shopping. Everything around us is done to persuade us to stay in consumerism, to be all about because you deserve you. You know, I was in a lot of airports this past week. And I would stay in them because my flights would get canceled because of the weather and all this other jazz. And you would walk around there and everywhere you would look. Advertisements, things that tell you your identity through shopping, through buying, through doing such as things like that. We are bombarded to stay in the trap of materialism in this nation. I remember in 9/11 how that was such a pivotal event for me. And that I was where I was and what I was doing. And you remember, do you remember those types of things? You know, that's a pivotal event. And I remember watching TV and what people had to say. And I remember President Bush getting on the TV. And he was talking about terrorism and how the economy is going to overcome and it will be fine and the stores will be open tomorrow. And he encouraged Americans to go shopping. Go shopping. Now, I'm sure he was trying to calm America down. But for us Americans, we cannot function without some level of consuming. Do you see the trap of that system? Do you see it? What is it going to take for the church in America to realize we cannot buy our way into heaven? Your stairway lies on a whispering wind, as the song says. We are not a part of the consumer society, but a part of the set apart body of Christ. Do we see the difference? Aren't we supposed to be different? Not followers of the system, but of the way of Jesus Christ. Or are we so far east of Eden that we don't see it? We don't see it. We don't see following the system, following the philosophies of the more we consume, the better our lives will be. You know, that's not the same as being a follower of the way. You know, Jesus was about the way, the way. Five times in the book of Acts, he talks about the way, the way. These are followers of the way. We cannot afford to believe that the gospel should affirm our lifestyle. Because when that happens, we make church a little nice little country club that is safe and nice and tolerant. And most of all, it's not a threat to turn the world upside down. Do you know you were called to turn the world upside down? To turn the world upside down. That the way that you would live would make people mad. Would make people offended. Huh. There's a lady who's sure all that glitter is gold. And she's buying a stairway to heaven. Could we say there's a culture who's sure all that glitter is gold? And they are buying a stairway to heaven? Again, to some extent, you have to survive in this world, in America, and there is a level of consuming we have to have. But here is my thing. Could you imagine a living organism, the body of Christ, being in unity, committed to live outside a system that hardwires you into giving them control of your life? As well as your lifestyle. Can you imagine that today? Isn't that what the body of Christ should be about? Could you imagine not being trapped into bills even? How many people are so frustrated of the way that they live because they never can get ahead? They always feel like they're one step away and they never make it. Can you imagine getting out of the frustration of the rat race? Or are we so entrenched in the living the way we have always lived that we say that it's impossible, that it can't be done, that I'm too idealistic? I don't believe that. I believe what the Word of God says and how to be set apart. I believe that we can live without Caesar as Lord and have Jesus as Lord. I don't want to just wait until one day the system collapses and we are not prepared as a nation. I want to be the church. I want to be the sanctuary for people to see another way a life. Just as the song says, is your shadow truly taller than your soul? Is the flesh, the carnality, greater than your spiritual hunger? You see, even the Bible warns us of this. You know, don't take it from Led Zeppelin. Maybe take it from the Word of God. And if you turn to with me to 2 Timothy 3, it gives you even a harsher warning. It gives you a really big warning of what I'm talking about and what consumerism does and what individualism does in our nation. And it makes us something that we should not be. It gets us distracted. I want you to hear the words of God. It says this, But know this, that in the last days, perilous times will come. For men will be lovers of themselves, lovers of money, boasters, proud, blasphemers, disobedient to parents, unthankful, unholy, unloving, unforgiving, slanderers, without self-control, brutal, despisers of good, traitors, headstrong, haughty, lovers of pleasure rather than lovers of God, having a form of godliness but denying its power. And from such people, turn away. You know, the crazy thing is when we read this, we think it's no big deal. We think it's, you know, this is really no big deal. All this list here, it's no big deal. I mean, take for example, the disobedience of parents and living in today's time. Think about that. Disobedience of parents. Do we think that's a big deal anymore? Or maybe we think, or you see it, it's more shocking to see kids behave rather than not behaving. You know, Steph has been out many times, and I've been out many times with our kids, and we've literally had people come up to us and say, "How do you do it?" Or, "You know, your kids are obedient." And I just want to say that's amazing to me to see. Praise the Lord. But they're so amazed because we don't see it anymore. Right? Or how about lovers of themselves? You know, people are crazy in love with themselves. Amen? I mean, every time it seems like you get together with people, all you want to do is talk about yourself. Let's talk about me and how you can love me and what you're going to do for me. You ever been a part of that? You know, this week I listened and I heard about marriages. And I just heard of a marriage that the girl wanted to go back to school. The husband didn't want that for his family, so she left him. Went back to school. Heard another, the husband stayed out all the time fishing, probably ice fishing, I don't know. Doing this, doing that. Wife left him with the kids, and he really doesn't seem to care. Now he's free. Talk about lovers of yourself. Wow. You hear people say, "It's my money, I made it, it's mine, it's mine, it's mine." If you're a body of Christ, it's God's. I mean, even think about it this way. We think it's normal. We think it's normal for every person in America to create a page on Facebook so that you can talk about yourself. And want everyone to look at them. Look at me. Look at at me doing this. Look at me doing that. I'm talking about myself too. Praise the Lord. Matter of fact, on the way home from Vermont, I heard Ivy League schools just came out with, by far, by a long shot, we are the most narcissistic culture to ever exist. And we don't see this as a big deal. That's what is amazing to me. Paul is saying it's going to be terrible. People in the church are going to be lovers of themselves, not lovers of God. They are going to be proud. They are going to be about my way or no way. They are going to be about the money, lovers of money rather than faith in God. That you can do things where two or more are gathered in my name. There are going to be ungratefulness. There's going to be unholiness. People are not going to care about holiness, nor to die to sin. Lovers of pleasure rather than lovers of God. Do you see that in the world? Lovers of pleasure rather than lovers of God. Matter of fact, do you see that in the church? Just take the example of churches these days. How many churches has drawn people in the church with great entertainment? With great entertainment, with pleasuring them. Hey, let's give them TVs on Easter Sunday. Hey, if you follow God, He will make you rich. Well, didn't the scripture say they will be lovers of money rather than lovers of God? If you make them rich, what? That's the same philosophy as the world would do for you. Hey, if you follow God, you will be healthy. You will have your family back. Don't you want God for you? That's the world we even live in. That's even in the church. Church, wake up. Do we see how far east of Eden we are? The gospel is not good news for your pleasure. It is for you to be, it's not for you to be whatever you want. You know, if you read 2 Timothy, if you go into 2 Timothy 4, he even talks about this, about you can find so many people to be who you want to be without being submissive or obedient to God. Did you notice that as well? Do you see that today? I mean, it literally makes me cry. Not when I look at the world, but even when I look at the church. Not even when I look at the church, but when I even look at the denomination of the Church of the Brethren. Whatever you want to do, I could find a teacher for you. Whether it is a Christian teacher, whether he has a PhD, whatever you want to do, they will tell you it's fine. If you want to stop believing in hell, I can find a teacher that can tell you that hell does not exist. If you want to know that God is love and only love, there's no jealousy, no wrath, no judgment, there's plenty of books out there about that. You want to be lovers of money rather than lovers of yourself? I can find you a teacher for that. You want to know everyone goes to heaven? Churches are all over here that will tell you that. It's not about you, the individual you. It's about us. It is about the organism of the church. It is about being a part of the body of Christ to move this world. Christ Jesus came to this earth not just to take away your sins, not just to give you eternity in His presence. He came to show you the way, to help you live in the way. He came to make you the body of Christ here on earth. He came to make you a part of a movement, a revolution, to be under His lordship so that you can turn the world upside down. He came to destroy the works of the devil. Are we doing that as the body of Christ? He came so that you would die. Die of self. Die in His baptism and be risen in Him with the resurrection power and victory over the power and principalities of this dark age. You cannot do that alone. That is why we are called to be the church. That is why we are called in a world, in a culture that is so individualistic, so separate, that it can't even be possibly done if we're not in unity and in one accord, with one vision, with one goal as a church. Am I making sense to you today, church? Of course, you can buy a stairway to heaven with individualism salvation, but you will never beat the system by yourself. You will never get yourself out of the philosophy of buying yourself a stairway to heaven. You will never think that you can turn the world upside down, because your brothers and sisters, your comrades in Christ Jesus, is there for you. You know, I've been bragging for 2 weeks now on this church of how we began, even in that process that I'm speaking of this morning, with giving up a possession that is of value. And you know how hard that is? Because you value it. Yet it is of the Lord. But here's the thing. I want you as a church to be creative. To be the church. You are special people. You are the priesthood of all believers. You are the pillar of truth for a world that does not understand truth, that has been lied to all of their lives, that continues to live for the system rather than for the kingdom of God. You can make a difference. We are all going to die someday. Will you make a difference? Will you be the church? Will you be the revolution, the movement that Christ started some 2,000 years ago? Or will you just live and die? Breaking free from living out the civilization of Babylon is very hard. It's very hard. And you know Babylon came up with the money system, right? You know Babylon will be destroyed in Revelations, right? You know in Revelation 18:4 it says, come out of her before that happens, right? Because you can do all things through Christ who strengthens you. May you truly begin to be in prayer of how to be truly set apart for the world to see. May you truly be convicted of to make a difference in this world. Not just sit in a pew and hear, but be doers. That will truly make a difference, not only in this community, but for the world to see. It's already begun. Even with this, it's already begun. And the Lord is going to use it greatly because you stepped out in faith. Now take another step, and another step, and another step. And all of God's people said, Amen. Amen.